Good morning, students. Welcome to the geography class. Today, in the second part of this chapter, India, climate, vegetation, and wildlife, I will discuss with you different types of vegetation in India. So, natural vegetation. Natural vegetation, the vegetation which grows itself without human interference. In our country, basically, vegetation can be divided into five categories. First is tropical evergreen or rainforest. Second is tropical deciduous or monsoon forest. Third is thorny or desert vegetation. Fourth is mountain vegetation. And fifth is mangrove or tidal forest. Students, first of all, I will discuss with you tropical evergreen or rain forest. Why this vegetation is called evergreen or rain forest? Because the areas or these kind of vegetation receives highest rainfall, and the areas or the forest, the trees in these forests are of different categories, and these trees remain green throughout the year because the shedding season of these different trees is different. Clear? And that's why these trees remain evergreen, because the shedding season of these trees are not the same. And these evergreen forests are also called rainforests because these forests receive rainfall, receives highest rainfall. And the forests are very dense. Trees are very dense. And some of these trees do not let sunlight to reach on the ground. And some of the areas are also very dark. These trees form canopy, and these canopy doesn't let sunlight to enter on the ground. So these are evergreen trees or rainforest trees remain green throughout the year. That's why these trees or these forests are called evergreen. So basically we can say evergreen trees are ebony, rosewood, and mahogany. And these trees are found in different parts of India, for example, Andaman Nicobar and near the Western Ghats. Here, the second category is of tropical deciduous forests. Tropical deciduous forests are also called monsoon forests. Why these are called monsoon? Because these forests receive rainfall only in monsoon season. So how these are different? Evergreen or rainforest forest receives rainfall throughout the season, but tropical deciduous forest receives rainfall only in the monsoon season. Clear? And these trees are not so dense, and trees are of same type. Their shedding season is same. Okay? So that's why these tropical deciduous forests are called deciduous. They are not like evergreen, because their shedding season is same. Clear? एक ही तरह के trees होते हैं, लेकिन evergreen जो trees हैं, उनमें एक ही तरह के trees नहीं होते हैं. Trees अलग अलग तरह के, उन सबका shedding season जो है वो अलग अलग होते हैं. लेकिन जो deciduous forest हैं, इनके जो trees हैं, इनका shedding season जो है वो same होता है. And these are also called monsoon forest. Then the main different kind of trees: teak, sal, shisham. Clear? And neem, peepal, these are the different example of these tropical deciduous forests. And in India, the states in which these forests can be found are Madhya Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh, Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh, and Bihar, Odisha. It means in our country, many states cover these tropical deciduous forests. I'm again repeating. In which states these tropical deciduous forests can be found? Madhya Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh, Odisha, and Maharashtra. Clear? Then third is thorny or desert vegetation. This type of vegetation can be found near the desert areas, like in Rajasthan, some border areas of Punjab or Haryana, then Gujarat. Okay? And the main feature of this vegetation is the trees of this vegetation: cactus, khair, babool, and kikar. and the leaves of these trees require less water and they can survive in less rainfall also. So that's why we can say that. And the leaves are kind of fine and thorny. Okay, so these kind of vegetation can be found near the desert areas or border areas of some states. Next is mountain vegetation. Mountain vegetation can be found on the hills, and these type of trees are called coniferous. Coniferous because the shape of these trees are like cone type. That's why these trees are also called coniferous. ठीक है, इसमें आते हैं चीड़, पाइन, देवदार एंड हाइट ऑफ दीज वेजिटेशन कैन बी अप टू 2500 मीटर. मीन्स दीज ट्रीज कैन सर्वाइव इन द कूल क्लाइमेट ऑल्सो द स्नोफॉल ऑल्सो एंड द शेप ऑफ दीज ट्रीज आर लाइक अ कोन टाइप एंड दैट्स व्हाई दीज आर कॉल्ड कॉनिफेरस फॉरेस्ट. Next is mangrove or tidal forest. These type of forest can survive in saline water, salt. It means these kind of vegetation or forest can be seen near the ocean areas, coastal areas, and in India, Sundarban, near West Bengal. This type of vegetation, mangrove vegetation, can be seen. This is also called tidal. Tidal because tides, due to tides near the areas, this kind of vegetation can be found. And most popular trees in this vegetation are Sundari trees. Timber of these Sundari trees is very durable, can be used for making boats, and due to its beautification, Sundarban. The name of you can say the delta area is Sundarban due to these Sundari trees. So this type of vegetation is very famous or popular near the West Bengal, can be seen. And this vegetation, tropical evergreen, deciduous, thorny vegetation, mountain mangrove, this forms the natural vegetation of our country. Students, forests are very important for us, for humans. Why? Number one, because it provides us timber, and timber is used for making furniture, fuel, fodder. Okay, then second, forests also provide us herbs and medicines. Its medicinal qualities are there. Then third is shelter to wildlife, home to birds. Trees provide shelter to many wildlife, wild animals and birds. Then trees also release oxygen and absorb carbon dioxide. And due to this, we can say that trees are very important to us. Even the roots of trees also control soil erosion. So in this way, we can say that these forests are very important for us. We should plant trees, we should not cut trees, and you should know the importance of trees in your life. Each one should plant a tree. Clear? Then next is about the wildlife of our country. This chapter is divided into three parts. I have discussed with you meaning of climate, seasons of India, four seasons are there. Then vegetation, five type of vegetation in India can be seen. Next is about the wildlife of our country. Our country is very rich in wildlife. You know, tiger is our national animal. And next, India is very famous for Asiatic lion. And Asiatic lion can be found in Gir Forest in Gujarat. Then elephants in our country. Elephants can be seen in the Assam state, Karnataka, and next is Kerala. One on rhino, rhinoceros is also very famous in Assam. Then camel can be seen in Great Indian Desert, Thar Desert. Then peacock is our national bird. Then in our country, government has set up many different bio reserves, the national parks, wildlife sanctuaries to protect this wildlife. Even Indian government has also started the project Save Tiger. Okay, then save endangered animals also. Then even in our country, in schools, we also celebrate wildlife week. Then Van Mahotsav, Eco Club, okay, and with the help of these information, students are given information that they should know the importance of natural vegetation and our culture. Even in our country, migratory birds also come from different parts of world. Many wild, you can say, migratory birds like Siberian crane, then flamingo, pintail. These comes in our country in the different seasons, and they arrive in December and stay till early March. So these migratory birds also can be seen in our country. So we should conserve forest wildlife, because this forest and wildlife have a great importance in our life. Clear? With this, I will discuss with you packet size, question answers. Tick the correct answers, friends. The world's highest rainfall occurs in Mozambique in Meghalaya. Then mangrove forests can thrive in saline water. Then mahogany and rosewood trees are found in the tropical evergreen forest. Then wild goats and snow leopards are found in the Himalaya region. During the southwest monsoon period, the moisture-laden winds blow from sea to land. Then hot and dry winds known as loo blow during the day in the summers. Then the states of Andhra Pradesh and Tamil Nadu receives a great amount of rainfall during the season of retreating monsoon or autumn season. Then Gir Forest in Gujarat is the home of Asiatic lion. Sundari is a well-known species of mangrove forest, and tropical deciduous are also called monsoon forest. So which winds bring rainfall in India? Southwest monsoon winds. Why it is so important? Because these winds brings rainfall, and rainfall is required for our agriculture, for growth of you can say crops like wheat, rice required rainfall. And in our country, farmers, many farmers, they depend upon monsoon to irrigate their farms. Then name the different seasons I have discussed with you. Different seasons are summer, winter, monsoon, and autumn. Natural vegetation grow itself without human interference. Different types of vegetation. Number one, tropical evergreen. Number two, tropical deciduous. Third is thorny. Then fourth is mountain. And fifth is mangrove. Then, what is the difference between evergreen and deciduous forest? Evergreen remain green throughout the year. Different kind of vegetation. Shedding season is totally different. But deciduous forest, that same kind of trees grow, and the shedding season is same. And evergreen remain green throughout the year, but deciduous forest never. Okay? Then why is tropical rainforest is also called evergreen forest? Tropical rainforests are called evergreen forests because they shed their leaves at different times of year. So with this, students, your homework is read the chapter and do the question answers. And with this, you have to learn the concept of different definitions in this chapter. Clear, beta?